We're a medium-sized county in Florida. We have about 215,000 total parcels, and a lot of those parcels, about 100,000 of those, are vacant lots. Our county back in the 50s and 60s was developed by a developer, and they went in and platted all these lots, and they were selling them, marketing to folks up north. So we've kind of were left with those lots. And those lots over the years have become speculative. Again, as our job as a property appraiser, we have to put a value on each property as of January 1st each year based on the sales and market data that we've seen. So it's challenging sometimes because we'll have a lot of these sales, you know, they look like they're arm's length transactions, that they're good sales that we should use in our analysis, but they may be, again, an example I give, you know, we have one sale for $10,000 and the one next door sell for $15,000. Again, we think they're both good sales, but we've got to make a decision. So we'll have to look at that and say, okay, which way do we want to lean? Do we want to lean toward that $15,000 sale or the $10,000 sale? We usually will take that group of sales. So if we have a group of sales in that neighborhood, subdivision, market area, whatever the case may be, we'll look at the median sales price. And the median, different than the mean, it throws out the outliers. So your average, your mean is gonna be usually higher than what the median is. So the median is gonna be the midpoint of all the sales arrayed. So we usually go to the median. But again, we still have to look at some of those other sales to see, you know, what weight did they carry? Again, we're running into the same thing. Like everybody is trying to find staff, you know, to replace appraisers. Somebody retires, they move on to a different county or a different profession. So we're trying to struggle. We struggle trying to find qualified people to come in to work for us. So it puts burden and stress on our people that are still there. They're having to pick up multiple, you know, loads. You know, picking up somebody's load who's left. So this would be, again, kind of filling that gap. It's not replacing people, but it's filling in that gap where we do have those gaps when we have turnover in personnel. So that's one of the draws as well, is that I know I'm struggling to find folks, but this will be, we can use this instead of throwing bodies at it. Hey, let's step back, use this technology that's available to us and use that as well. We have 200,000 properties we have to appraise every year. Again, each and every year we have to do that based on the sales from the prior year. So the app allows us to go in to these certain areas, you know, and we can filter down by market area, neighborhood, whatever, how minute or we want to get in that data, those properties, and select those properties. And then it's going to give us that AVM number, and we can choose. And some of them are going to be right on. We're going to feel good for that. We can check those boxes and upload those into our system and not touch them again. Or we say, no, we don't accept that value. We're gonna look at those more closely. There's something, you know, it may be a unique property or whatever. So we'll have to spend some more time, extra time on those. But again, if we pull 100 out and put those right up into the system that we're good with those values, again, we don't have to spend time on those. We concentrate on those handful that we didn't agree with. So that's going to be the beauty of it, that we have that flexibility, that we can choose or not choose the AI value in our analysis.